What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo, and in today's video, I'm coming at you with another custom Patreon requested video. This one is coming from Gabzy. So Gabzy, I just want to say thank you so much for supporting me on Patreon. In today's video, we are actually jumping back into checking out more RBD. I didn't realize so many of you guys were going to be such a huge fan of that video. I had never heard of the group prior, and a lot of people wanted me to keep checking out more of their live performances. So in today's video, Gabzy wants me to check out A Tu Lado and Fuera. I've no idea, but I'm super excited to get into this. Before we do, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel. You guys can follow me on Instagram and Twitter. If you guys like reading books, things like that, I also have a BookTube channel. I would love for you guys to check that out as well. Links are in the description. And with all those things out of the way, of course, I'm gonna put on some good headphones, and I'm excited, dude. I remember there was like so much energy in the first one we checked out, so I'm really excited. We're gonna watch what this is, 9 minutes and 54 seconds, and I'm assuming it's gonna be pretty tight. Let's go. I just love that there's so many members.
Y la lluvia en el camino, a tu lado sé que está el destino.
Okay, you already know that people are like huge fans of a group, a band, or a song whenever you can get just a handful of notes out of a song and the entire crowd goes nuts. You can hear the fans screaming the song. I like her vocals a lot. The red hair. Damn. So one thing I already like about this song compared to some of the other ones that I checked out last time was that I feel like in the other ones there was a lot of vocal separation. So like one song we would have the entire group, the next song would just be like the three women in the group. And what I like about this is that not only do we have all the members here, but they were all singing at once and like harmonizing together, which is one of my favorite things on this channel.
Que golpea nuestra barca, a tu lado sé que estoy en calma. A pesar de lo difícil, a pesar de nuestros besos, a tu lado nada me da miedo. Tú me vuelves invencible, no conozco lo imposible. Si volteo,
I love the harmonies in this song. Little guitar solo happening back there.
Thank you.
Oh my god. Look at this fan just running. Okay, I gotta say, for a group, this is one thing that's really crazy to me is that, like, every single country is going to have that one group, one band that is, you know, they're sort of, like, known for. And every country has it, even smaller countries. But one thing that's so interesting, especially with this channel, is that these are artists that I've never even heard of, right? Never even come across my timeline, never in my life until some of you guys start telling me about these artists. And I'm looking at the stadium right now and it is completely packed with people. Like, so many people, this is their favorite group. And I just think that's so amazing because, like, no matter how much you think you know about music, there is still so much more to learn. I just want to say that even with a slower song like this, what I love is that they were really utilizing those moments for everybody to sing together, really bringing in sort of that, like, that passion and emotion of the song. I also love that they have a live band because I think that always adds, you know, you could just have these songs played on a, like a CD, on a sample in the back and them just performing. But actually having a live band really brings just so much more energy to these. And even when it's a slower song like this, you can feel it. The crowd is absolutely loving this and I'm here for it. The next song that they're gonna perform, I think, is Fuera. So let's do it. Aww. Damn, he's got some good style here too.
Hola Rio!
Look at this, he's got like the all denim suit going on here, you know, the cowboy suit. And then he's got some Air Force Ones on, but they're like some crazy colors. Tight.
Quiero agradecer el hecho de estar aquí para mí. Esto es un sueño. Y esto es gracias a vocês. Y quiero dar un mensaje muy rápido que creo que es importante que todos sepamos. Y este es el sentir que yo tengo con respecto a lo que voy a hablar. ¿Para qué hacemos? El ser humano hace tanta muerte. De repente prendemos las noticias y vemos guerras. Vemos noticias que realmente no nos llenan, simplemente vemos cosas que nos entristecen. ¿Para qué hacer guerra si a país no costa nada? Las únicas personas que ganan con la guerra es el ego de los gobernantes. Y no podemos permitir más eso.
Fuck yeah.
Si tú, que estás allá, no importa si estás en la primera fila, no importa si estás en la segunda fila, quieres paz, levanta tu mano. Al igual que tú y yo, queremos paz en esta tierra. Estamos cansados de tanta muerte y de tanta injusticia. Te amo, Brasil.
Here, dude, okay, you guys already know, if you check out this channel a lot, I fucking love what he just said. I love that entire speech. We're talking about a full stadium here, and I feel like these days, artists are more inclined to make these speeches and come out and talk about these things. But I think this is obviously a little bit older. This video may even be like 10 years old, I'm not sure. And still coming out and making those same speeches, and we're still dealing with those same things today. But it's amazing to see a group, an artist, a band, whatever, that has so much exposure, using that exposure to really talk about issues that are going on. And I love that because music brings a lot of people together, but when I think about the things I believe in, the things that I hold true to myself and things like that, I learned all of that, you know, veganism and peace and things like that. I learned all of that through music. So when you can see artists that you idolize, that you love, that you, you know, you want to hear their music, you want to talk more about them, talk about those same things, it really does make an impact. So I really, that is just a beautiful way to, you know, I don't know if this is a transition into a song or if it was just him wanting to give that speech, but it's really beautiful. Love about this group is that, you know, transitioning from that last song into this song, I feel like the sounds of these songs are so different. There's such a different vibe to these, and whereas that other one felt much more emotional and a little bit more laid back, this one is directly in your face, a lot more energy, a lot more aggressive notes coming. And also, I still don't know what the girl with the red hair, I don't know what her name is, but I love her vocals so much. They sing in a little bit higher of a range, and it just sounds super cool for this. Oh, and that guitar solo, every time.
No vengas ya, ¿qué quieres que hago para que no molestes más? No traigas regalos, ya vete, ya voy a cerrar, que ya me estás cansando, no llames ni me busques más, no, no me estás desesperando. No me dejas vivir, ya no te soporto, me estoy enojando.
Yeah. I'm just gonna take it back just a little bit so I don't interrupt too much of that guitar solo. I love how much energy this group has. I talk about, you know, them transitioning with different sounds and how they really just kind of morph into that sound, but there's just so much energy when they want to bring it. And again, I don't know how far into the concert this is, but I remember checking out the other video that I did, and it was only like the first three songs or something, or the first two songs, but like, they had already done so much that I couldn't imagine how they could possibly go another hour and a half into a concert series and still have that energy. But you're seeing it right here. I mean, they, like, I like that when they're performing, they give it their all. Like, you're not just getting them singing. They're actually up here, like, doing this whole choreography and everything, making you feel like you're a part of it.
No
fuck? Okay, well, I gotta say that I love the tracks. I think I noticed right away, I love the tracks where the women get the lead on this. And the reason being is I think I haven't seen enough of the songs with the dudes to really see, like, what impact they bring. Of course, obviously, I love the emotional song that we checked out at first here because I love the harmonies a lot. But what I noticed is it seems to be the higher energy songs, which are more sort of in the lane of what I like to listen to. In those higher energy songs, we actually get a chance for them to come out and they really just own the stage. They bring a lot of these aggressive notes. They really just kind of like bring the fire to this. So I really love checking out those types of tracks. I am going to be continuing to listen to RBD on this channel because turns out a lot of you guys like it and I like it too. The one thing that kind of sucks is I don't know what they're saying lyrically, but sonically and from a performance base, there's a lot to appreciate. So even though I don't always know, I am appreciative that there were captions here for that speech that happened in the middle, because that definitely like made me even more stoked about this. But I really hope you guys like today's video. I just want to shout out Gabzy. Thank you so much for supporting me on Patreon, letting me do all the things I love, and choosing this to be your monthly custom request. But I hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, please make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel. You guys can follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Links are always in the description. And I hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace.